Let me show you how you can set up and use the Power BI Gateway to connect to on-premise data. And we'll also talk about the personal versus the enterprise mode. But before we go any further, I wanted to clarify something I wanted to share a tip with you that you do not need a paid Power BI license to use the Power BI Gateway. There's some confusion around this out there, but again, at least as of right now, you do not need that. So you can try it out, set it up for yourself, even if you're on a free Power BI license. Now, this video is part of a series on Power BI gateways, and this video itself is going to focus on Power BI gateway in personal mode. Our next video is going to focus on Power BI gateway in enterprise mode, and the video before that, our very first video in the series, talked about when do you even need the Power BI gateway, what does it do, and are there any ways to avoid having to use Power BI Gateway. So make sure to check out all of our videos in this series. They're going to be linked in the corner or down in the description below. So let's get going with Power BI Gateway in personal mode. Now, my name is Avi Singh. I'm a Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI Pro, make sure to subscribe. And yes, my friends, click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. Now, if you are just getting started or keep getting stuck in Power BI, also make sure to check out my number one ranked Power BI tutorial and start creating beautiful dashboards that would surely make you popular. All right, well, same thing, linked up in the corner or down in the description below. So Power BI Gateway in the personal mode, let's go through these steps, how to set up, how to use it, how to connect to your on-premise data. But before that, I'll just do a quick recap of when do you need the gateway and what's the deal with personal mode versus enterprise mode. When do you need the gateway? That's really simple. When you publish your models to powerbi.com, you need something in there to give you the ability for the cloud to connect to your on-premise data sources when you're trying to refresh the model in the cloud. And that is where Power BI Gateway comes in, and it acts as a bridge between the two, from the cloud to your on-premise data sources. Now again, this is covered in a lot more detail in my first video, so make sure to check that. And yes, we have that bonus section on how you can avoid having to use a gateway, so check that out. So let's talk about the next part, which is the personal versus enterprise mode. So if you launch the installer, which we'll talk about in a second, then this is pretty much the first option it's going to have you choose, which is, hey, do you want it the option A, which is, you know, we call it the enterprise mode, or option B, which is the personal mode. What are the differences between these two? Well, the personal mode is really, as it says, it's meant to be used kind of one person who's the model author. So again, if you're the model author, maybe you're the one-man army, you know, the one Power BI superhero in your team, and if you have tens or hundreds or even thousands of users using your reports, that's all good, right? But the one author can install Power BI Gateway in a personal mode so that they can refresh their own models. And then as many users can use it as have access, right? So it's mostly focused on the authors, not the report users. So that's the personal mode. And the other mode, which is the enterprise mode, now this is in the scenario where you have a lot of different Power BI model authors in the team. So there are different people building Power BI models in Power BI desktop and then publishing it to be used by different groups. So if you have multiple model authors, then you might want to consider the enterprise mode, because then you can set up one gateway which will allow multiple users to use that gateway to connect their models to on-premise data sources. And it has some other differences too. Again, this was covered in more detail in my first video, so you can go back and watch that. So now that you know what it is and the difference between personal and enterprise mode, in this video, we're gonna focus on the personal mode. It kind of acts very different. And then in the next video, we're gonna focus on the enterprise mode. And we'll also talk about, hey, is it possible to maybe start out in personal mode and then switch over to enterprise mode? We'll talk about all that and more. So let's get going. And again, with this video, we'll focus on the personal mode. Oh gosh, I should really breathe once in a while. All right, I get excited about this stuff. So where do you download and install Power BI Gateway? That one is simple. You go to powerbi.com and sign in, and you're gonna have this nice little icon. You click on that, and then from the dropdown, select Data Gateway. That's gonna let you download the installer. Now, once you have that, of course, the next question might be, well, okay, where am I going to install it? Well, that question is often easily answered in personal mode. Hey, truth be told, personal mode installations almost always end up on that person's personal computer or laptop. That's what usually happens. And that's totally cool. Now, if you can find a machine that stays always on and is connected to a wired network, that's cool, but again, not a requirement. It's okay to do it on a laptop, which is connected over Wi-Fi. There's gonna be some impact. We'll talk about that later in this video. The enterprise mode, which we're gonna get to in our next video in this series, does have more considerations. You wanna be a lot more careful, and we're gonna dive into that in our next video in this series. So the personal mode, you start the installer. It's going to give you again the warning that, hey, computer should be always on. It should be preferably on a wired network. But again, I mean, it's okay to ignore it. It's okay to put it on a laptop with Wi-Fi. And we'll talk about the impact later on. And the next screen is going to have you choose the red pill or the blue pill. No, just kidding. Between the enterprise mode and the personal mode. And of course, in this video, we're going to talk about personal mode. So you want to select that and then go from there. It's going to have this exciting visual here. And the next thing is going to talk about these minimum requirements. Now, if you check that out, it's not much. There's some recommendations. But again, for the most part, any modern laptop or computer you have should be fine working as a Power BI gateway in personal mode. All right, so hit next to that and please wait. And after this point, it's going to say installation was successful and is going to ask you to sign in. Now here, you need to sign in using the same account you use to log in to PowerBI.com. And as I said earlier, this can be a free account. Power BI gateways do not require a license. Isn't that cool? All right. And after that, once you're signed in, it's done and the gateway is online and ready to be used. So you have probably done that on your own personal laptop or computer or some other computer you could find. At this point, now we're going to switch over and really the rest of the settings need to happen on PowerBI.com. So let's switch over and look at that. All right, but before we go to PowerBI.com, I wanted to show you the Power BI file that I have. So again, this is me as a model author. I've built this awesome model. Okay, it's just a dummy thing, but you'll get the idea. And what I wanted to show you here was the data sources that it's connected to. So I'm gonna bring that up, and you can see here that it's connected to my very local Excel file. So it's sitting on my C drive and my local SQL server as well, right? So again, local on-premise data sources. And of course, when I'm working in Power BI desktop and I hit refresh over here, everything works because I'm kind of within my internal network and I have full access to my hard drive and the SQL Server as well. But of course, problem starts when I publish it on PowerBI.com and then if I would try to refresh it there. So let me just publish this file to PowerBI.com. And I'll be right back. All right, so look at that success message, woohoo. So my file is published on PowerBI.com. Now it's living on the cloud. And again, I can share it with 10 or 50, 100 or 1,000 users. And of course, for sharing, you do need a paid license. But that's gonna work. But of course, you might wanna have this file automatically refresh, and that's where the Power BI gateway gets in. So if you look at my workspace right here, then you can see that my data is kind of set kind of showed up there, and of course I have the report, and of course in a realistic setting you probably would have dashboards and stuff as well. Now either you can click on these three vertical ellipses, whatchamacallit, yeah, so you know what I'm talking about. So you click here, and these are the two options that we are concerned about, refresh now and schedule refresh. You can also access them, I think, from this menu. I'm not sure why it's not showing there. All right, cool. So what we're going to do is come in here and say refresh now and watch what happens. Something went wrong. Something definitely went wrong, and it's telling you a message right here, because this data set requires a gateway, and then it leaves you in this dialog box. Now, one thing that I wanted to show you was, if some other videos and documentation may talk about this, clicking on this gear icon and clicking on manage gateways, I just wanted to make it clear that they are talking about gateways in enterprise mode. If you do that, and if you click on manage gateways, you may be surprised that, my personal gateway doesn't show there. But again, they're not supposed to. But they do show up. You can still use them. They just don't show up in this managed gateway thing. So again, let's go to gateway connection. And in here, as promised, your personal gateway does show up. So again, it wasn't showing up in managed gateways. But once you open the gateway connection options for your files, if you have personal gateways set up, then they are going to show up. So we're just going to say use a data gateway. And that's turned on. And we're going to click apply. And you're not done yet, because again, as you notice that it also needs credentials. So let's go back to our diagram. So Power BI Gateway does give you a path from the cloud to the on-premise data source. But when you're working in Power BI Desktop, you know, your credentials are kind of stored here on your machine, and they're used when you click refresh. And you can check that out in your data source settings. But when it's in cloud, glue on edit permissions, and that's kind of where your credentials are stored. But when it's on cloud, you just need to provide the same credentials again. So Power BI Gateway is giving you the path, but it's saying, okay, I'm going to go traverse the path and try to talk to this data source, but what credentials should I use? And that is this part. And again, you're just going to click edit credentials and provide that. Now, this might vary depending on what your setup is and how your domain account is set up and so forth. So let me just click that and I'll be right back. So I have provided the credentials and it looks happy over here. And at this point, I am ready to refresh that database. So again, what I'm going to do is go in here and click refresh now, and we'll see how that goes. All right, we are back, and you can check your refresh status using this refresh history. So let's just do that. And look at that, our on-demand refresh, that's what Refresh Now shows up as, was completed successfully. And if there were any rows that were updated or removed or deleted, they would be reflected in the data set over here. Now, of course, at this point, you can also click here and click on Schedule Refresh, or this window is open right here. Let's click on that. It's basically going to bring you back to this page. And there you can set up a scheduled refresh. Now, the free license, I believe it allows you to refresh up to 3 times a day. And on a paid license, you can refresh a lot more frequently. But again, the Power BI Gateway, scheduled refresh, Refresh Now, all of that can be used on a free license itself. All right, I just want to show you that I did set up the scheduled refresh, set it on. Now, interestingly, it did allow me to do 8 refreshes, and I'm reading up and it's not clear. It seems the free may allow you the 8 refreshes per day as well. If I remove this, it allows me to add another time, so up to 8. And Power BI Premium, which is a lot more expensive and covered in our separate tutorial on licensing, that one allows 48 times per day. So that's scheduled refresh for you. And again, Power BI Gateway is just going to let you run that using on-premise data sources. Make sure to check out all of our other videos in the Power BI Gateway series. Our next video will be coming out soon, and once it's available, it's going to be linked right here in the corner or down in the description. And of course, check out our #1 ranked Power BI tutorial and get started on creating beautiful Power BI dashboards that blow people away. Until next time, power on, my friend. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.